guys, Jessica Henry here. Just wanted to welcome you again today. I have a really fun little thing I wanted to just talk about real quick. I thought it'd be fun to do, since Mother's Day is coming up, to do just a little watercolor of a bouquet of dandelions, because what mom hasn't got a little bouquet? So I have my little bouquet here. I'll show you that. That's what I'm working on. And I haven't even started. I haven't done anything, so I thought that this would be kind of fun just to start from the beginning. All right, good to see you guys. Thought I'd just kind of chat a little bit while y'all got on. I know I didn't announce what time I was going to be on because I wasn't really sure, but I thought that, you know, lots going on. So here we are, and I thought this would be fun. Okay, so what I'm going to do, this is just for when I start my watercolors. I'll show you my supplies here. Hi, guys, good to see you. Good to see you. Oh, in case you're just joining, I'm going to do a watercolor of some little dandelions. Yeah, I thought it'd be kind of fun for Mother's Day. So I thought these would be fun little tips if you happen to have a little bouquet sitting around your home that you could do just a quick little sketch. So this is how I would do it. I'm going to turn you this way so that you can see what I'm working on. Good to see you guys. Okay, so here's my supplies. And I think if I can just angle this down a little bit without the sky falling, then we'll be okay. And then I can still kind of see your comments. Okay, so here we are. I'm at my dining room table today. Sometimes these make the best studios. It's all bright and airy in here, so here I am. Okay, supplies. I have my Arches watercolor paper. I'm just using 140-pound hot press today. I like hot press because I find cold press just kind of it's too toothy. Hi, guys. Okay, pencil. I'm just going to use a 4H. I had a really great question earlier this week, and somebody had asked, how do I keep the pencil from smearing all over the paper when I do the watercolor over the top of it? And to answer that, I use a 4H. A 4H pencil doesn't have really loose, crumbly graphite, so when you do a wash over it, it pretty much stays in place. So it's, there you go. I do have my nice little sable brush here today. This is a size 6, just a round. Okay, you can use the synthetics too. This is basically more or less doodling today, so I'm gonna have some fun just playing. Then I have my paints over here. Gonna wake up my colors. I just take a big mop brush and I just put a little bit of water in each one, just like that. And I'm gonna let those just sit while I draw the picture onto my paper. And I have my natural sponge here. You can use paper towel or whatever. Just have that there. Just a soft plastic eraser. Okay. You don't want a hard eraser like the pink pearls or the ones on the end of your pencil erasers, because they damage the surface of the paper. So you don't want that. All right. So I've got my little bouquet here, and you can see it right here. I'm going to move this over so it's a little bit out of my way. And I'm all set. This is what I love about watercolor painting. It is just so simple and so clean. Okay, so here we go. I'm gonna hold this up a little bit so you can kind of see a little bit better of what I'm doing. And I'll try to get your comments. Good to see you guys out there. So we have a train that is close to our house. You can hear all kinds of, my windows are all open, so you're gonna hear all these noises. All right, so let's see. If I put my flowers in about this kind of proximity here, I'll put one over here. Dandelions, you have to work so fast on. I've done a number of these mother's bouquet paintings, and they're just so pretty and sweet, and they're so informal. They just kind of, it's just however your kids hand them to you. Hi, Norm, good to see you. Okay, later. Sounds good, thanks, Norm. So I'm just drawing sort of the circular shapes of where these are going to go. I hope that you can see that for right now. Probably doesn't work. To see this, but I like this one going way out like this. That is the thing about 4-H is the pencils, is that it is hard to see, at least on video. But I will get some more sketch in here, and then you can maybe see a little better. I'll press a little harder than I would normally if I was just doing this on my own. I want some of these green leaves in here. My daughter picked some of these for me this morning, and so I have, I don't know if those are, I think they're cherry blossoms, and they're so pretty. So I'm just going to sort of suggest those in there, and the little twigs as they come around. I do like these angles and the way that these twigs just go this way and that way. And this little clump is over here. And then I liked how this one came up, across, over. And then there's this really pretty clump of them up here and some green. So really, for watercolor, I'm just going to sort of loosely draw these in place, just to suggest a few. And that sort of gives me a ballpark of what I'm going to be working with. I do have to lay this down a little bit so I can finish getting the rest of it in place. So I'm looking to see where the cup intersects these lines over there, and just going to assume that those are about in the right place, just to give me a sort of a ballpark of where the rim of that cup is going to go. And then straight down. And then this one comes under that flower. I know a lot of people don't really care for dandelions, but I like them. I've always sort of had the sympathy for them. They're just doing their business, happy to be alive, first flowers to come out. And then people want to get rid of them. And little kids just pick them for their moms because they're flowers. So I love that. All right, so the stems kind of float around in the water down here. And when I paint this glass, I'll just suggest some of those values and the changes in the water. Just, I'm not going to get really fussy with, you know, all the little teeny reflections and things in the glass. Just keep it just simple. This is just a fun, simple study today that I thought it'd be really fun to share. Okay. Okay, so that's giving me sort of a ballpark to work with. Yesterday we started our first lesson for the Renaissance Academy of Fine Arts, and it was so great. We're getting great feedback, and if you're not a member of Renaissance, you need to look into it. It's just, we're doing really wonderful things there and very excited. Got a number of people signed up, and it's very encouraging. It's we're launching this academy, and we're starting with just ground zero, basic beginning drawing, and moving our way up through the years, actually, working. The first five sessions are going to be drawing, then we're getting into more watercolor and Victorian color theory. Then we're going to get into very simple working from photos, landscapes, plein air. We're going to go out to plein air painting, and then working with live horses and portraits, working from life that way. Everything's online, and I do worksheets with every single lesson. So there's a lot of years going into that. Okay, I'm satisfied with this drawing, and I'm gonna jump into getting some painting on it now. My colors are all woke up. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna work from a little bit, just suggest some of the background here first, and then I'm gonna work on just some of this. No pen and inking today. All right, so what color should I be to the background? I'm guessing maybe I'll push the gray of this tablecloth and make it a little bit more bluish or violet. So I'm gonna grab my ultramarine blue. Over here, if you can, yeah, you can kind of see that. Okay, I'll move it a little bit closer. Nice big puddle, lots of water. Let's grab some alizarin crimson, just because it's so pretty. And that makes a really pretty purple. You know, I should have had a piece of scratch paper out to test these colors, but I didn't grab one, so I'll just wing it. All right, gonna clean my brush off. I've got a decent little puddle there. I don't want it to be really big. I'm not gonna go over this whole piece of paper. But what I wanna do first is I'm just taking clear water, and I'm gonna go around some of these flower areas a little bit, just for the background, just to suggest where some of these things are gonna go back there. Like that. I know you can't see really, it doesn't really show up, but so while that's wet, let's just dab in some of these purple tones, colors, so pretty. Wipe the brush off. If you wipe your brush off a little, then you can sort of move that paint around a little bit in that those puddles as they drip around, they're movable, so you want to just kind of play with those a little. And I think that that's a nice subtle shade for the background. It's nothing too distracting. I hope that's visible. Okay, good. All right, moving along. I think that this purple will be really pretty with the yellow of the flowers too. And I really don't need to see a whole lot of the image right there, but I'll move this out of the way. Okay, so with the light coming in from this direction here, I'm gonna let this kind of just fade away a little bit over here. And I'm gonna rinse my brush off, dry it off, and just let that puddle go clear as I wash it down. And over here, while it's still a little wet, I'm gonna go a little bit darker, grabbing more of the pigment. And I'm gonna pull that down. I wanna see what I'm doing. Maybe a little bit more blue as I work into this shadow over here, because I really wanna highlight that. Can you see that right behind the glass, that highlight where the light is shining through the water of the glass? Good to see you guys. Hello. So I'm leaving that, the white of the paper. I'm gonna go around that, wipe the brush off, and then bring the dark around down here. Just like that, nice and subtle. Nothing too big, nothing too big, fussy. The beauty of watercolor is in the freshness. Okay, so let's get some more. I'm gonna mix up sort of a gray tone. So let's get that lavender back again, the alizarin crimson and ultramarine blue. And then to neutralize that, to make it a little bit grayer, I'm gonna add some burnt sienna, just a little. And you can see, it kind of makes it a dusty lavender color. You'll see it when I get it on the paper here. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna focus on where I see this in the background of the glass. So it's just a little bit of a separation of the color tone where the glass meets the background. Just a little, just like that. This is sort of the Victorian style, but it's just, I don't know what you'd call it, easy breezy watercolors. Is that a name? It is now. I gotta move this over so that I can see. Good to see you guys. I'll come back through here and do the stems over this color. Let's get a little bit more burnt sienna and blue in there. Just burnt sienna and blue, even in oil paints, will give you a nice gray color. So let's get some of that in here. And one thing I do love about this sable brush is that it holds a nice point, and it holds a lot of pigment in there too. So I'm gonna go up the side over here, because I do want that separation of the glass from that passage where it's getting on that table. Clear, wipe, and move that gradated puddle around. Okay. Just like that. And I'm dragging that right back into that shadow back there. And let's do a little on this side too. Just about like that. Okay, and then I'm just gonna do a really thin wash of it on this side of the glass, dragging that puddle down. Rinse my brush off, clean it out, and just drag a little bit more. Just really simple. And streak in a few little lines. Trying to see my arrangement and hold the thing so you can see it. Okay, so let's get into some of those flowers. I want this to dry a little bit. I'll go like that. Just let that do its thing. Sometimes if I'm at home and I'm in a hurry, I'll just take a blow dryer and blow it off. at these flowers up on top, these blossoms. So I want to get a nice light springy green to start out with the leaves. So I'm grabbing just some of this yellow, lemon yellow, a little bit of ultramarine blue. And then I'm going to paint the leaves where I saw them. And just start out with just a simple wash. You can come over it later with a little bit darker tone. And some of these little lines in here. And just a little up there. And anywhere I see these little green patches, I'm going to just dab that in place. Just like that. Come back through. Put in a few little suggestions of other leaves. Even if they're not really in that place, it's okay. And then I have this same color. I'll just use it on the stems of these dandelions too, since I have it already done. Follow the line going right up to the flower. A few more down here. It's pretty simple. All right, now I'm going to mix that green up. Even while the yellow or the green on here is just a little bit wet, that's okay. I have a little bit darker color over here. I just added some more blue to that. And just put this in where I see some of these darker passages in the leaves. And just, you don't have to get super fussy. Just put it down and let the puddle just do its thing there. Just like that. And I'm going to just dab a little bit of dot, dot, dots, because these little blossoms over here, I see these cute little, almost like little spritzers of the, I guess they're cherry blossoms. If you've watched my videos long enough over the years, you know I come up with my own anatomical names for plants and fruits and whatever else. I mean, who can be bothered with technicalities? All right. And I think that this should have a shadow on that side of that leaf. Just a little bit of, I just have the two values on the leaves. I think that's all it needs. So I'll just put a little bit down here for this dandelion. A little bit down here. That's it. Okay, so before I get much further into the dandelions, I want to do a little bit of just shading on some of those flowers up there. So I'll make a nice gray with burnt sienna and ultramarine blue. Maybe a little more blue than the sienna. Okay, so this is just I'm going to put this just where I see some of these petals up in here, just to suggest a few. Seeing where these doing their thing. And then I'll come back through here and put in the little centers where I see those. All right, I'm gonna add a little bit more blue to some of this just to add some variation. Sorry if I'm missing your comments, but I'll have to get to them. When I'm done, I think that that puddle is a little too dark, so I'm just going to dry my brush off and soak some of those up. Just like that. And then over here, most of these petals over here are in shadow, but I don't want to completely cover in all of the white. Now I'm going to come back through here and with a darker green, I'm going to use cad yellow medium and ultramarine blue. That's what I'm mixing up over here. And that now I'm going to sort of give these flowers a little bit more definition, right in the middles. I'm going to dab that in place, just for the dark part, and then I'll come back through with the little green sparkly things. Okay, and then over here there's just a few. Okay, I think that's fine. Maybe those petals are too dark. All right, what I want to do is get a teeny little brush out right here, and I'm gonna do the little like that. This will be kind of fun if you can see this. Just a little, it's like stippling. The problem with these teeny brushes is that they run out of paint really fast, so you have to keep going back for more. You don't want to go too crazy with this. Just suggest a few. It'll feel like blossoms. Just draw on a few more of those little stems. And then down here too. Don't we need music? I wish that they'd let us put music on Facebook Live. Thank you, Sylvia. Good to see you. I just thought, you know, such a pleasant day. It's a spring day and my yard's full of dandelions. Let's share the wealth. we're all gonna learn how to paint dandelions today. My kids have given me so many bouquets like this over the years. So I'm trying to be really selective about where these are gonna go. I don't wanna just kind of put them willy-nilly. I'll just carefully choose, like that. Okay, now I'm gonna take some alizarin crimson over here with the same teeny little brush. Alizarin crimson, burnt sienna, because I'm seeing some of these, like last year's cherry little twigs, those are still hanging on. Let's get a little blue in there so that it's sort of a darker red, and then we'll start putting in those. So you make a line and you give a little pressure at the end, and it has that illusion of like a cherry stem. Yep. You don't want to do too many, but just a few. So I'm kind of marking out the stem of this gnarly little branch, like that. And we'll get some more burnt sienna on there. That's what I'm doing over there in the palette. A little more water on there. I don't mind that got a little bit dry brushy. If you can, I'll hold it up so you can see a little bit what I'm doing. Okay? Thank you, David. Getting that a little darker because as I come down this twig, it's a little grayer and blacker. Burnt sienna in there. Twiggy, like that. Yeah, I think it needed that little bit of dark line just to help the composition that way. Okay, and then this twig comes down like this, and this is actually down in the water. Sorry if I'm waving this all over. I'm trying to see the thing and hold it up. Okay, so that goes with that guy. All right, let's do those dandelions. Bring that brush down. So I'm gonna start with the lightest yellow on the dandelions, and I still have this from last time when I did the daffodils, my fancy Praying brand yellow. Praying watercolors, you know, those sets that you get when you're a kid. Yes, I should have gone to the store and just bought some nice yellow, but you know, I had it, and so Praying is actually a really good brand, and I'm not disappointed with their quality at all. Okay, so just gonna take this clean, pure, bright yellow, and just gonna draw on basically where the petals go, and then I'll dab in some brighter orangey yellow into the center. So here we go. I'm gonna start with this one over here. Again, back to my nice sable. And these are mapping out the shape of where I want the petals to go, the shape of the flowers. Just let each one of those have its own integrity. That, grabbing some cad yellow medium, just gonna put that right in the middle while it's still wet. Just let some of that play around. Okay, rinse my brush off because I want that bright, clean yellow for the next flower. Over here, there's one that's kind of hiding. We'll just sort of suggest that one back in there. Okay, next. Never knew dandelions could be so easy. These come down like this. And I love the irregularness of the petals and how some are stuck together and some are kind of spread out. So I just go around like how little kids draw sunshines, you know. And grab some of that darker cad yellow medium right in the middle. Just like that. Okay. I want that to be a little bit more regular there. All right, and now as I'm coming around and these are a little bit more in shadow, I'm gonna use a little bit more of the cad yellow medium. And I might even put in some of the, I have cad red light and some yellow ochre, so we'll get into those darker shades of yellow on these, just to give it a little bit more dimension. So jumping in here with this one in shadow. Again, same process. I'll push those shadows back in there a little. Okay, now let's clean this off, get some yellow ochre. Into that, I'm gonna make a separate pile over here of yellow ochre and cadmium red light. Okay. So here we go, over here, grabbing that mixture and gonna make this a shadow. I still need a little more because it's just too wet. If you get too much water in it, it's hard to gauge, so you have to, you don't wanna add too much water. Okay, I think that's fine for that one. Okay, and then cleaning my brush off, we'll get this one back in here. Like that. That one can just hang out in the shadows. You know what, while I'm thinking about it, let's just give this one a nice dark center there. Sorry if I'm missing your comments, I will try to get at them later. Okay, so then let's get this last one in place. And it's pretty much just facing the background. Let's get that brighter. Oops, that puddle's running away. Clean that off. little darker. Let's do darker in the middle. This one, kind of right about. Don't want to lose the shape of the flowers. Sort of like which direction they're looking in, if that makes sense. Okay. All right. Now I'm just going to come back through here real quick and do a little bit more color on the stems of these flowers. And I am going to do one more thing to the dandelions before I wrap this video up. But I want to get these stems a little bit more defined here in the water. Yeah, I think that's better. It just needed a little bit of definition. Okay, now I'm taking the teeny brush again, and I'm just going to come back through with a little bit of detail in here. Not too much, because I do like how fresh it feels right now, but it needs something, a little more. So let's just get a nice darker mixture in here. And I'll just come through here with some of these, and I'll draw a few little lines in place to suggest a little bit more of the what's going on in the middle of the dandelion. And so all it really needs is just a little bit like that. Let's get some nice bright yellow down here and over here. I like how some of these feel really fresh still. I think that that's kind of has a nice feeling. I like the white of the paper kind of sparkling through. No, Laura, this is hot pressed. I like hot pressed for just doing some more detail work because I find I can get in there a little better. Cold pressed just tends to me to be a little bit more rough. Although it's just a kind of a personal preference. Okay, maybe I'll just add a little bit of yellow to these blossoms up here just so that they feel a little bit more like blossoms. And then it kind of ties some of that yellow up and around. I do have to fix the rim of this cup before I go crazy because it's kind of off a little bit. It's difficult when you're kind of sitting on top of an object to get the drawing, just so. But, okay. No excuses, right? There, that's okay. All right, what next? I guess that's about it. Just a fun little study. Yeah. All right. So I'm going to kind of wrap this up. I will post this a little bit later on Facebook if you wanted to just see how I did that. And you can have that to refer to. Anyway, so again, just wanted to thank you for joining me. If you're interested, we are now accepting enrollment to the Renaissance Academy of Fine Art. And we started our first class yesterday. It's not too late. You can sign up anytime. Videos stay on your member page along with all the worksheets. And we have a very exciting plan for the whole year. And yeah, you can pay as you go. You can buy it in segments. Like if you just want the drawing, if you just want the oil painting, whatever. So we have lots of options. Take a look. I'll put the link to the thing right up here at the top. All right, you guys, thanks so much. Have a fabulous weekend and enjoy your spring. Okay, bye.